The first USS Savannah started out as a 44-gun frigate and was later converted to a 24-gun sloop of war. She participated in two wars and also served as a training vessel at the U.S. Naval Academy. Joining me to discuss the history of this Savannah is museum interpreter Bobby Hughes, a.k.a. John Adams and Captain Moses Rogers. Hi, Bobby.
Hey, Woody.
So, Bobby, I understand that of the four USS Savannahs, this one is your favorite. Tell us why.
Well, I've always been a fan of the American Civil War, and she served in the Civil War. I've always been a fan of square riggers. She's a square rigger. And she also played a significant part in my native state's history.
Which is?
California.
And about your uniform today?
The uniform I'm wearing is the working uniform of a Union sailor during the Civil War. They wore blue wool year-round. They could alter their uniforms by removing their neckerchiefs or just wearing their undershirts. White uniforms, there's a myth that they were worn in the southern climates. They showed oil, grease, dirt way too often, and were just not practical for life on board of a ship.
Well, during the war with Mexico, Savannah served as the flagship for the Pacific Squadron and managed to capture the city of Monterey, California without firing a shot. Bobby's going to tell us how that occurred.
Savannah and her sister ship Cyane sailed into Monterey Bay with no resistance. The garrison at the Presidio had no ammunition, and actually the Presidio had no garrison. The Mexican troops had all fled to Los Angeles. The mayor decided that discretion was the better part of valor and surrendered to the two ships. This, with the surrender of San Francisco Bay to the USS Independence, pretty much cemented American control of California.
And what were her activities after the war with Mexico?
In 1853, she was sent on a cruise off the Brazil station, off of South America, where she ran into a storm that knocked her on her beam ends. In 1857, she would be laid up and converted from a 44-gun frigate to the 24-gun sloop of war.
And then, as you mentioned, she also went on to serve in the U.S. Civil War.
Her first station was Hampton Roads, Virginia, as part of the North Atlantic Blockade Squadron. Then in late 1861, she was sent down, probably because of a sick sense of humor at the Navy Department, to take station with the South Atlantic Blockade Squadron off of Savannah. While there, she helped capture the blockade runners E.J. Waterman and Cheshire. In 1862, after a brief bout of scurvy, she was sent to Newport, Rhode Island to the Naval Academy, and she remained there until 1870 as a training ship. Then in 1880, she was sold for scrap.
Well, in the museum's archives, we have a letter written by a young midshipman named Channery Thomas Jr. He served aboard Savannah during her last training voyage in 1869 to Britain and France. In the letter, he describes his activities in Portsmouth, where he boarded the HMS Victory, Lord Nelson's flagship. In the letter, he wrote, "She was the one which he, Lord Nelson, commanded at the Battle of Trafalgar, where he lost his life. And I put my foot in the spot that he fell." Join us next time as we take a glimpse at a Savannah which served in the Confederate Navy.